Welcome to Alme. We're here to share tech knowledge with you. Let's get our journey started. Windows Modules Installer Worker is a core Windows component that checks and installs updates for Windows and other Microsoft products. It plays an important role in keeping your system running stably, but at some moments, it may cause abnormally high CPU usage and make your computer lag. So how to solve the problem of persistent high CPU usage? This video provides you with the reasons and corresponding solutions to ensure that your computer's CPU usage is back to normal. Don't miss it. Part 1. Reasons for Windows Modules Installer Worker High CPU. Part 2. Solutions to fix Windows Modules Installer Worker High CPU. Let's take a look at the reason first. It is a normal situation that Windows Modules Installer Worker or TIWorker.exe is using high CPU usage when you update your Windows version. It will gradually decrease after the update is completed. However, if it still maintains high CPU usage for a long time after you update your Windows system, it may be caused by a technical fault, corrupted system files, virus infection, or wrong update. When you are looking for Windows Modules Installer Worker High CPU solution, you may receive some suggestions to disable it, but it is not recommended by us. All you have to do is to follow the methods in the next part to fix it. Please keep watching. Method 1. Delete the software distribution folder. The software distribution folder is mainly used to store new Windows updates. If there are corrupted files stored in this folder, it may cause high CPU usage problems in Windows Modules Installer Worker. In addition, Windows 10 will automatically generate a new folder with the same name when a new Windows update appears, so there is no risk in deleting the software distribution folder. We need to temporarily disable the Windows Update Servers to avoid errors when deleting this folder. Type services.msc in the wrong window, and press Enter to open the Services window. Find and right-click the Windows Update Servers. Then select Pause or Stop in the drop-down menu. You can refer to the above method to turn on the Windows Update Service after the problem is solved. Next, open File Explorer on the desktop. Then go to the Windows folder, locate and right-click the software distribution folder. Then select Delete in the drop-down menu. After restarting your computer, then navigate to the following path to refresh Windows Update. Method 2. Restart Windows Update Service. Type services.msc in the wrong window and press Enter to open the Services window. Scroll down to find Windows Update. Right-click on it and select the Restart option in the drop-down menu. Method 3. Change Windows Module Installer and Windows Update to Manual. Open the Services window. Find and double-click Windows Module Installer in the right list. In the Windows Module Installer Properties window, set it to the Menu option. Then click OK to save this change. Find and double-click Windows Update in the right list. Set it to Menu option. Then click OK to save this change. Type Control in the wrong window and press Enter to open the Control panel. Find and click on the Windows Update option. Then click on the Change Settings on the left. Change the settings to check for updates, but let me choose whether to download or install them. Then click OK to save this change. Finally, restart it. Method 4. Run Windows Troubleshooter. First, click Start and select Settings, Update and Security, Troubleshoot. Find and click Windows Update. Then click the Run the Troubleshooter button and follow the prompts to execute the repair process. Method 5. disable Windows 10 automatic updates, find and click the update and security option, and click advanced options in the right window. In advanced options window, scroll down to pause updates and click the option box to select date you want to pause the update. Method 6. Scan and repair corrupted system files using System File Checker tool. Type CMD in the search box and select Run as Administrator. Type this command and press Enter to execute it. The System File Checker tool will run automatically. You just need to wait for the process to complete, then restart your computer. Method 7. Use the DISM tool to find and repair Windows corruptions. Type this command and press Enter to execute it. Next, you just need to wait for the DISM tool to automatically scan and repair your computer's corrupted files. Method 8. Perform a clean boot. Type this command and press OK. In the System Configuration window, under the Startup Selection section, select Normal Startup and click OK. Then restart the computer and make the changes to take effect. Method 9. Press this combination key to open Task Manager. Find and right-click TI-Worker.exe, then set priority to low. Method 10. Stop trusted installers. Type Rigidit in the Run window and press Enter to open the registry editor, then navigate to the following path. Find and double-click the start file in the right window. Then set value data to 3 and click OK to save the changes. If the above methods couldn't fix the problem, and you have backed up your system before, you can solve the problem by restoring your system to the previous version. An Elmi Backup Standard would be a good choice to help you achieve the goal. You can Google Elmi Backup Standard and download it for free and use it without registering an account. Just a few simple steps to backup and restore your computer. Then you can use your computer normally. Want to know more about Elmi? Looking for more tech knowledge? Just subscribe us and leave comments. We're here to help you with your any issues.